and this your organization Prison Atma Manthan, this prison organization I am knowing about from a since it was formed by the Preeti Tagbe, and today I get the opportunity and she invited me such a nice manner, so I can't refuse to that. And this topic is Atma Manthan, that is my topic, which I always realize that all the women, they should realize how they can contribute to the nation, in what manner they can contribute to the nation for building of our nation. Because we are in a developing country, when we have to become a developed country. At that time, our 50% of the population of our country have to work for that. Now we have got, in this COVID-19 situation, we have a rejuvenation, which I feel in these four months duration, we are rejuvenated during our lockdown period, and we have a introspection for the woman. Because as rightly said by the Preeti, at that time they are a multitasking, they are doing so many things, and the women are the center of every family. And in Indian context, the women are doing a lot. And now they are also educating, and they are educated, so they are well off how to do the things and contribute to the system. And when these women are contributing to the system, it goes to the nation building. And we are a part and parcel of the nation building. So we have to recognize to recognize the others and put our whole effort what we can do. Every woman have her own quality. So their own quality, their own interest, they can contribute. That like in a rural and urban woman, there are a difference. In all rural and rural women, they are doing a lot. One example I would like to quote here, in a rural woman, like two examples in a business, they have given the example, like in a Lizard Papad and another is a Amul. And in urban women, so many examples are there. And in pharma professions also so many examples. So we can come, we can do. So we can do how we pharma peoples, pharma women can do and contribute. So looking to the what they have, what are the intrinsic qualities they have. So I have prepared some few slides. What we have, what are the facts? Because this situation we have to develop, because we have to go through that, how the woman, in which areas the woman can do. So I would like to share my slide, which I have prepared to go through that. So I would like to, Preeti, can you do that?
I'm screen share from your side.
So which I have prepared, and the facts which are
ma'am, just
the topic which I have chosen is the honor of the woman in Indian society. In our society, Indian society, I have chosen this Indian society. Indian society, the nature of the woman is different, and in Western world is a different. After a long, long time, they had got the opportunity to vote for their leader in the foreign. But in our country, we are already empowered, we are already a leader. But when we look to the ancient time, during the Upanishad or this time, we are powered. But due to the middle age, mid time, some degradation, some in the honor, because of some environmental conditions, it was reduced. So they have lost their honors. But now the modern time has been come. At that time, the women, and now time the women are also educated and they have a degrees also. So they can come up, they can lead their life. So now the rotation from ancient time to that time is a very fruitful time. At that time, the woman can do. They can contribute for that. So the honor in our country is always here. Now we want to become a Vishguru. So for that time, Vishguru we were earlier. So this time, if a woman are contributing by their wholehearted effort, whatever they know, they are full of their quality, so they have to contribute. So then our country will become a Vishguru. So we all have to work for that. So that is my appeal to all pharma professional women and also my youngsters. So which I have prepared an honor for whatever they are doing for that. First, we have to look for the water, our Indian society, because we all have a 24 hours in a day. So in the Indian society, multitasking nature of the woman, as in a survey report which I go through, that it has already given ki women are multitasking. They can do more than one, two or three work at a time effectively. So, and our Indian society is a hierarchy society, and India offer astounding variety in virtual every aspect of the social life. And this social life is dependent on the society norms. So these, what are these society norms? Because these society norms helping them, they are helping them, and sometimes they are also make a hurdle to them. So these, what are these hurdles, and what are the effectiveness and giving the environment to work for the woman? These norms are social norms which exist in our country in these days. These are the social norms, are the unwritten rules. These are, this means of that. The social norms are the unwritten rules of the behavior of all the population, men and women both. So these are rules of behavior that are considered acceptable in the group or the society. So that knowledge a woman should have. What are the behavior of the environment? What are the culture? What are the traditions? And what norms of a group wherever she is walking, wherever she is moving? So the woman should have a knowledge. So the norms function to provide the order and predictability in the society. As we are the developing country and we are want to be a developed country. So what conditions the woman, with their culture, Indian culture, with their culture, they can contribute. So what are the different factors? If they have a knowledge, then they go with their factors. What factors, up to what limit they can go through. So the norms gives the, these norms function to provide the order. So what order, in what way they have to work, and what will be the predictions? Because whatever the woman will do, the consecutive results she will face. So they have to learn from there, keep what will be the results of their one action. So people want the approval. Everybody need the approval, acceptance of the society. So the people want the approval, and they also want to belong. If we make any organization, everybody wants, the everybody should accept that. If those are not in their organization, not accepted by that, or if they are not accepted, they want to be, they belong to them. So they want to be. Just one example I would like to quote here, like in a BRNCP organization. In this BRNCP organization, that is a Mansoor organization, we are established there. So in that organization, anybody, any professional, pharma professional, if they have some link, anyhow, any link, they want to become a belongs to. We are, have a connection with the BRNCP. Another example I would like to say, BHU. That is an organization, it's a big organization, world famous organization. In that organization, any link to the BHU, everybody wants to belong to that. They always quote, I belongs to that organization. So that organization, this is a human nature, this behavior of the person. So through that, they want the success. They contribute to the society. So that nature and that require, not the requirement can say, that nature of a person, that behavior of the person. So for this, who do not follow these norms will suffer a disapproval in the society. A group have some rule norms. If the person is not accepting that, not under that, so they will suffer. They will suffer the disapproval from that group of the people. So that knowledge of a person should have, or may even be outcast from the group. So we should be a role model. We should be a rolling path in the pharma profession. Always they should be in a profession, because we are the pharmacists. We are recognized by the others in the society as pharmacists. So when we are looking in this COVID-19 situation, in the COVID-19 situation, we are also a healthcare professional. But initially, everybody, in our leaders, political leaders, our educators, our all organization leaders, our health ministers, and everybody, they are just telling the name of the only the doctors and the nurses. But nobody is telling about the pharmacist. But after some time, when we realize these pharmacists are selling their products, they are working in the hospital. So after 15-20 days, they also added the word pharmacist. So we have to realize themselves. We are also a part and parcel of their healthcare system. So in that direction, our pharma professionals also have to work. We have to recognize how they can recognize, are they in the society, by their potential, by their competence, by their working, by their making a recognition. So that area is every pharmacist have to work on that. So, and in COVID-19 situation, this webinars and the seminars, the instance learning have given a platform to come to each other and work for them. Exactly. So that is a positive thing happened in our in COVID-19. In overnight, our senior professionals becomes the technocracy. In every higher education institution, the seniors are not coming in that. Only few 1 or 2% are coming in the techno-savvy positions. But this COVID-19 positive things has been happened. Seniors are coming in the techno-savvy manner. So no complaints for that. So this is a positive thing, because their experiences have had to the youngsters and the students how they can proceed and contribute to the system. So these norms are very important. This is how we keep the society functioning. And not just with the direct rules, but also the expectations. Every organization has their own type of expectations. Everyone. So what this expectation, they fulfill or not? So these expectations match with their nature. That nature will be matched or not. So then they will be the part, they may belong to them. So that's why the other different organizations, name and fame and their standards, they meet out. Because of, based of the expectations. So my experiences which I faced that, where any organization, the expectation is nothing. If any organization, no expectation, but they are freelance to everybody. And inculcation of everyone. And acceptance and then creation. Then the organization will be the big. When the people know what is expected of them, they tend to comply with them. This is the need of that. So while some people seek to be different, most just want to be a part of the group. That happens with the norms. So norms can be changed according to the environment, situation, and culture in which they are found, and people's behavior will also change accordingly. Time to time, as in higher education, they have started to change theoretical classes through all our theory classes as a through the virtual class. No need of to come to the class. No biometrics is there. Only your attendance through the virtual class. So it keeps our teachers techno savvy, and they become also more effective. 100%, which I have seen in most of the principals when I had a talk, so they are saying they are 100% attendance was there. But in classes, 100% is a problem. So it means this is a good sign of the COVID-19 output. So the norms, we have to work according to the environment, according to the what is the today's need. So then we become the developed country. So that we have to adopt. But in our Indian society, we are always reluctant to accept the new thing. So the social norms regarding the public behavior, I would like to say something, because when we are, because this topic is related to your Atma Manthan, and Atma Manthan, in their Atma Manthan, when we are talking, because if we are working in the virtual environment, in that virtual environment and in the meetings and the during any interactions, so some basic rules and regulation which depends on our norms, which was earlier, but now is due to we are looking for something is happened. So what are the basic norms? Just to go with that, I just read out that the basic social norms regarding public behavior we should have, we should learn, which is missing in some of the organization I saw. My experience, maybe the whatever. So first, which in young generation and in also our senior professors and the leaders also, sometimes I face that for their behavior, make direct eye contact with the person you are speaking with. This is very important for the woman. Always they should have a direct eye contact with the person you are speaking with. And do not curse in polite conversation. If anybody's conversation is very polite, then do not curse that. Then don't interrupt someone while they are talking. Wait for them to finish and then take your turn. Put your phone on silent if you are in a meeting. So that is a basic thing. When we always saw that the webinar is going on, some ring bell, the phone will ring that. So be respectful of their coworker. Don't shout on them. So respectful, if you are want a respect, then you have to respect themselves also. Then they will respect you. If in any organization is a respectful behavior to anyone, co-workers like your teaching officers and your non-teaching officers, everyone, your students, everyone you have to respect. If you are respecting, then the environment will be positive. That is need of the hour. Looking to the woman honor. So the woman honor is a matter of carrying out, acting and living the values of respect. This is a society norm, according to the society. And the living the values of the respect, duty, loyalty, selfless services, integrity, and personal courage. That is very important for showing their honor for a woman. That personal courage to say she is good. That is missing in our Indian system. Nobody is coming to say that you women are doing in this area, you are doing well. In this area, you are doing this well. So many areas they are working and contributing to the nation. But nobody is coming to say that. So we have to recognize them and saying them. This is a pleasing respect to honor them. So in such a way, we can honor if a woman is doing in good. So in everything a woman can do. So every woman is a unique woman. So we all should do that. If someone honors a woman, they recognize. It means they are recognizing and award her for her achievement. If a small certification program she attended, and if she is taking that certificate, and it will contribute to the any organization. We are working in the academic organization, it will contribute to the honor of your NIRF ranking or your accreditation or your UGC marking. So every respect, they are contributing. So we have to recognize that, yes, you did well. Mostly the term honor has always been a word used to describe a woman of high moral worth. It is expecting by the Indian society. They should have a high moral worth or great achievements. But it is well known for men. So such high moral values and the great achievements is required for getting the honor for a woman. But looking to that, the traditional facts for a woman, they are serving for that. The women are considered to be caretaker of home. They should be. They are doing their duty. So they had to look after the running of the family smoothly. This is a traditional mindset of a society. They had to manage the expenses in the most economical way possible. And they had to look after aged in-law and nurture their child, like all these things. So they were expected to obey orders of their husband, the elders of the family. But kept in isolation when it came to major decision related to the family. She is devoting everything, but at the big decisions, they should be the woman should be far from that. This is a traditional mindset of the person, which in traditional mindset in our country is more than 80% of the families. More than 80% of our population, they are doing that. So this is a question mark for the society. We have to change our mindset. So this things is to be coming picture. So women should have to understand these things. See how, what can they do? So what can, how they can do their own presence in the system, own presence in their family. They are doing everything, but how they can do in their presence in our decision making, because work from home. We can say that जब किसी के का growth होती है, तो वो growth भी आपकी घर से ही चलती है. तो जब तक आप घर में decision making नहीं करोगे, how you can be a leader from outside world? So you have to first participate in your policy decisions in your home. Then you will become a decision maker of the society. So that there should be this mindset of traditional nature of the families should, she has to do. She has to make some protocols. She has to come with this. In modern day, the facts which she is facing, most of the women in current scenario, the urban women have completely transformed from being a mere homemaker to the modern day multitasking women they become, and handling responsibility without fear. So the fear they come out. Without fear, now their women are coming. Even they are doing everything in their family. So they taken off the world with confidence because they are doing the work without fear. And women in today's, they are handle their duties and course at home, everything. Like in traditional traditions, they are doing. That time, they are not educated, not degree holder. They are educated, but not degree holder. Not a working woman. Manage a career outside their home and nurture their children and balance their family lives with their professions. Everything they are doing, a modern woman. Although they are doing everything, the modern day women are independent because of the financial support. The one report which we have prepared and the survey report, when the woman become the financially strong, financially independent, this independency is due to their financial independence. So this independence has given with the fear from. They are without the fear, with the confidence. This financial independence has given their free from fear and the confidence in them. So at that level, at below the age of the 40, and then we look to the Indian average age, that is 26 years of the age. Average age of the India is 26 years. It means less than 40 years. And average age for contribution of for nation building is only 45 years. After that, deterioration starts. Nobody thinks about the any new ideas. So our India age is 26 years of the average age, and women are contributing. And these women are, if a person have a confidence, then the person can contribute in a own way. When a person do the own way, then they can think whatever the need of our country. So this financial independence make them confident and make them fearless. So that independence takes right decision boldly and stand up for their rights and walks the path of the success. So that is the need of the hour. The women, those are financially independent, they should think on that and contribute for the nation. They are daughter of India. They should feel that. They are daughter of India, not only one family. So they have to contribute. If a person, how we can know? When we know, a few examples I have quoted here, Kalpana Chawla and Sushma Swaraj, madam, Aishwarya Rai, Susmita Sen, Kangana Ranaut, they have faced lot of things for their success. So they are not a person of a one family, but they have contributed. Why we are quoting here? Why we are seeing them? Because they are contributing to the country. They feel they are a daughter of India. So my appeal to all the women, they should feel they are daughter. They have to work for their family, but they have to come out from their self by doing any own methodology, own studies. They have to opt in their families and come out to contribute to the nation. So to become, to add their name in this series, like in Kalpana Chawla, Sushma Swaraj, Aishwarya Rai, Susmita Sen, and Kangana Ranaut. Kangana Ranaut, now you know the how she is standing in there. So these are the facts, and the facts, every woman should have a get the opportunity, but their intrinsic quality is very important. How they want to be and how she can. And what print she has, footprint she is leaving, after that the another younger woman can catch it. One thing I would like to say here, continuous exercises, continuous fight, we can say, and the support from our counterparts and the system, and the system in our Indian society, the women are going to educate. Government has given not too much help to them. Free of cost education. That is a government contribution. So that everybody can educate them. Feticide, they have dropped. So all these things has made the woman strong. So they are coming in the education, and once the, a woman is educated, and these women is educated, then both side of the family in our Indian traditions, their maternal part and their in-laws part, both part of the family become educated. That is the strength of our Indian system. So the every woman have some restrictions also, some reluctance also. So she has to come out from their self and do something. and contribute to the nation building. So the activities of women are in all sides of the present day economy in the India. As we saw in the Amul and in the Papad is a big organization, they have stand up. They are the rural women. They did that because of their confidence. And they are in Lijjat Papad, seven ladies grouped together, just seven friends they are. Seven friends grouped together and start preparing the Lijjat Papad. And now it is a 43,000 women are working in Lijjat Papad. So that is the inherent quality, leadership quality of the women. If they can do, the why not the educated and we pharmacy workers can do. So we can do, we can contribute. We can establish a big empire. We can do. In healthcare professionals, we have a different sectors to work. We can counsel our in a hospital. We can adopt our villages. So in such a way, we can recognize we are the pharmacists, we are healthcare workers, not in only a one-week program of the IPA, National Pharmacy Week, but continuously in routine practices. We can do that. So this has proved that the woman can be even better because they have a lot of ideas, multitasking nature, and different thinking of. Not a monotonous type of the thinking. The woman have a, because of their working nature, the woman have a different type of the thinking of the society. They think society in a different way. So they can be a better than their counterparts if they are given an opportunity. Because women, as we see, I was going through the survey report, one of the survey report, I was seeing that at the leader positions, only 2% of the women are leading there, but none other. So why they are not coming? And in a pharma industry, I go through that and I saw there only 38%. Women, but in a healthcare profession, in the healthcare team, only 38% women are participating.
Exactly.
They are now at that level. So we have to come out from their self. The skills, how they can come out, the skills which is required for them, so their thinking should be changed. So the scientific excellence depends on the creativity. For any industrial development, for any pharma education development, because we are the pharmacists. So the pharmacy is the pharmaceutical sciences is related to that. So the scientific and the creativity emerges from the diversity as a woman have, inherent quality of a woman. So they have a diversity and that the advantage of the diversity are realized through the inclusion. So the woman can do, and their inclusion in their leadership positions will make the difference, will contribute that much better way as compared to the men. So being able to think on their feet, the women should think on that and quickly come up with solutions are highly valued skills. Because their skills and way of presentation will be different than the counterpart. So they have to make their own strategies, own solutions, because they have also to look after their families and their societies too. And they are the part and parcel of their traditions. They are part and parcel of their culture. More responsibility in Indian system as compared to the other. So they should taking time for themselves. And always a woman should have a plan B. Whenever a woman is working, that is a plan A. When they leave, sometimes they leave there, they do not have another plan. So that mindset of woman should make their mindset. If this is not possible, then another we can do. So that at a time, 3, 4, 5 plans they should have. So that attitude a woman should develop themselves. This is a need of the hour for contributing to the system. So that leadership skills makes them leader to do that. So how they can develop their skills? if they have a, they develop the confidence, they should be affirmative in their work. They should break the cell, whatever the cell they have made, the out of the box idea they should, they will have. They should be enthusiastic. They should be self-motivated. Nobody will motivate them. They should be soul-motivated. I have to contribute. Every day, they should contribute. And they should be inspired. If they are contributing anything. So the woman, one woman can inspire to another woman. So the networking is required. And they know their qualities, what the qualities they have, what are the conditions they have. And they are looking to their conditions, how they can contribute. They do not go for the, another woman is doing this much, so huh, I should also do. No, they should, under their conditions, they should know their qualities, how she can. So every individual woman is a unique woman, and everything is required in this world. So the, every woman has to know their own quality, own restrictions, own inherent things, how she can do that. So that things the woman should understand. That is the need of the hour for become a, for contributing to our nation. The woman leaders in pharma profession. So many woman leaders has come up. So how they come up, what they did, these are the examples. They have empowered each other to reach our full potential. And they have given the mentoring system to our other women. And they have made the networking for the women. And they are provoking the industry for giving a good environment, safe environment, and some rules and regulations, looking to the conditions, looking to the situation of the women. So environment, friendly environment is required, and educational norms if they have. So these are the few examples, basic requirements for giving, those are the leaders are already achieved their goals. They put the their contribution. So this in the current status, the progress appears only in early career stages. Most of the women are coming. And in the gender gap is still considerable in senior positions. As I said earlier, only 2% women are in leader position. When we look to the in pharma education, none of the women is there. In a pharma education, only few they are coming. But at the top, none of the women is a, in a education, MHRD or in any organization, they are not. So we have to come up. And in initial stages, below age of the 40, they are coming. And most of the 70% of the women in the classes, when we look for 70% of the girls are coming. But after the marriage, they are leaving. So we have to motivate them. These are the younger generation. So according to the American Association of Pharmaceutical Sciences, I'm quoting here, not this data, because we are looking for how we can come up with the, our Indian society. So the American Association, in 2017 survey, when they look for the salary survey, the salary system, the female membership in AAPS at 38% is higher than in several other professional societies. This is the highest contribution, but not the more than 50% or up to 50%. This is a salary structure they have surveyed for. Okay, you are listening?
Yes, ma'am, you are audible.
Yeah, yeah. No, I'm completing just. So, this is a survey report. Lot of efforts by the pharma industry has been done, but up to 38% only. And highest percentage of women contribution for nation building is in pharma profession only, as compared to the other branches. IT and other food and other branches like that in engineering or in pharmacy, in health professions and so many professions. So only in the pharma profession is up to 38% they have got the women contribution. And women have such a much to offer in terms of diverse viewpoint, because this is because of their the quality. So they have a diverse viewpoint and a transformational leadership style. So they think always for the future, and we're looking to the earlier one. So that diverse point of view is the need of the hour for developing country. So it is not a monotonous, but divergent relations, divergent type of the thinking, it makes the vibrant nature of the system and make the healthy and wealthy type of the atmosphere in the system. So that is the only quality. This is the main quality of the woman. So that quality, the society has to accept, and more opportunities has to given, and so the more and more women will contribute. So this contribution will make us the Vishwaguru in education and a developed country in our country. So that is the need of the hour. So few examples I want to quote here. Kiran Majumdar, everybody should know. Sure, she is the chairman, managing director, Bicon Limited. She established this Bicon laboratory on biotech products. And Preetha Reddy, managing director, Apollo Hospital Enterprises. Swati Piramal, everyone knows. Vinita Gupta, CEO of Lupin Pharmaceutical. These are the lady, pharma ladies. They are doing with their efforts. They are also a lady. They have faced a lot of problems at that time. So they are doing that, but they did that. So with these examples, and thank you for some presentations, which I just like go through that, what is we are doing. So thank you, Preeti.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Okay.
Can you stop screen? Thank you so much for the wonderful deliberation, ma'am. It's really that women empower, like women are proof them herself in each and every field, whether as a researcher, a woman has proved herself as a CEO, entrepreneur, as a philanthropist, as a academician, researcher, in each and everything, every field, she has proved that women are best. It's not no comparison. Like we say that the dominancy and anything, it's nothing is there. And really, there are so many questions which I received. Particularly that being madam, she is working, you are working in the field, so I received many of the questions that what are the biggest challenges working women face, and how we can be overcome by these challenges.
This is dependent with my experience, which my views, my opinion, according to that. So for a leading position, as I already said, the only 2% women are there. And at the below age, because is 40 years of the age, the women are not taking that position, in a leader position. They are not taking. But they are just working and enjoying the things.
Exactly.
But now the time, the women should come up. They should take the leading positions. And one thing in the challenges is when you are in a leading position, then you have to face and compete with their counterparts. So the expectation from the woman is as such, as similar as the other counterparts that they are working. So is it not possible? The woman is a unique person. They have a different type of the nature. So mindset of a person, at the time of the selection, at the time of the interview, at the time of the Viva or any places, at the leading positions, the mindset of the society to be changed. And they are always expect the woman, whatever the woman have done on that criteria, they select them. But in men, I am going to the different way. In men, they only judge their potential. No work done is done. So that difference made them. So for that part, one of the organization in the Germany, 10 women has made the artificial intelligence inclusion. They have made the criteria. And they are given if we are using the criteria based. So the women, more and more women can contribute and more women for the interviews can be through the interviews can be selected. So artificial intelligence can help as are already are four examples I have quoted here. They have done that they, because of their unique nature. Everybody is helping to them. So that mindset, traditional mindset in our education system to be changed. So they are quite capable to do.
Hello. Yeah, exactly, ma'am. And this is all the mindsets we have to go through that. And I just Dr. Madhusmriti Kundai, she is from the Orisha. She has dropped. She is having one question that do women in pharma profession have a hard time getting promoted? This is.
No, if actually in the woman. It depends on the age. Though we're 40 years of age, they are not interested to get any promotion. So that promotion they don't want because they are more concerned with their families. So at that time, they should not think only the family. As I said earlier, they are not only for the family. They have to contribute to the nation. If they are working, so if they are... they are quite capable, they have a good quality. As we see in the any convocation, they more than 80% women are getting the gold medal.
Exactly.
So if they more than 80%, so it means they have a quality for teaching also. So they should come up and take the leading position. If a qualified person and educated person and knowledgeable person is coming at the top position, so they can contribute, they can teach the, they can run the environment much better way as compared to the other one. Those have a less knowledge. So the women should come out from their self. So they should take the position and take the help from their counterparts or their co-workers. So they can take them. So they should take their position. Don't deny for that if they are getting the chance.
Very well said, ma'am. Everything is in our hand. Like we have to compete, whether it is the promotion, we need our capabilities, we need to renovate, we need to upgrade ourselves. Because once we don't have the quality and we are not proving ourselves, how we can promote, how we can ask for the promotions? It's really a practical approach.
Yeah.
And ma'am, being a woman and you are in such a big positions and you are working, you are managing your home as well. So are what I'm just asking to you that are responsibilities at workplace and the social life affecting your health and it's something increasing stresses? So how you can manage with all this thing?
When you are in a leading position, and a director or any national organizations, at that time you have to face a lot of things because everybody want to be at that position. Everybody. So for a lady, being a lady, my personal experiences, so you have to face. But one thing is there, if you are quite capable to make your strategies, then you will win the situation. You have to see your own inner qualities with due respect. Then you will find the ways and means for doing the work. So that makes you leader. And the old traditional mindset will also remove from that from the society. So we have to own individual intrinsic qualities. We have to make them.
Exactly. it's a real fact that we need everything in our life. Like if you have to go for the official trips and the trainings for upgradation, your career developments, and so what majority issues you face and how you deal with the priorities and the family responsibilities, again the same thing.
So for that purpose, for family priorities, you can take help. So like in a woman, they
especially this question is asked by 80% women, then how we can manage both the things.
Yeah, so you can take help from your in-laws or from your servants. So make them happy. Servants should be happy if kids are very small at that time during their adolescent stage. So the servants, your duty to that, because man, mother is a mother is mother nature, no one can give that. So that mother feeling, no one can do that. So that mother feeling is very important to develop the psychology of the kids. So help from in-laws and help from the servants, you can use at that time. So and manage them, and husband also help you.
So every definitely.
Time you are there, always, because they look after them. You are not at home, the husband will look after them. So they are seeing their everything for them, for the in-laws and for the kids.
When I go through the questionnaire round and I ask people that generally I talk to the men, he said, what question we are going to raise, because it's all centered and here now the women are more dominant. And one question from Dr. Sunil Singh I have received, what tips and advice would you like to give someone interviewing at Women Empowerment?
Or first of all, in our Indian society,
exactly,
the women have to introspect first what qualities they have, identify their qualities, what she can do in their circumstances and in their in the situations. So first, her mindset is important, how she can, and then once she has decided, then after her decision, she should be confident and affirmative. Yes, I did this. I am affirmed for their own purpose. And she should always speak with their purpose. Not every time for just here and there. So with the purpose, they always put their things. So this is my advice to the youngsters. They
One question, thank you ma'am so much, one question that I have received, that being a blessed by God, beautiful creation as a female and given ability to give life, have you ever thought that hormonal disturbances and the maternity duration become the hurdles in the work?
At time, I think it's not a hurdle, just management, and so many therapies are also available. So it will not hurdle, I think so. So only the time of their childbearing. At that time, 3 to 5 years are already we are helping. At that moment, it is not a, we should enjoy the 3 to 5 years with the kids also. So younger generation. So they should enjoy. So that is a created, the God has given, we should enjoy. At that time, we should not see the professional life. Only enjoy with kids and their jobs, because financially they should be independent. And exactly. After that, these 3 to 5 years, so after that they can cover up. But during that time, she should plan. Future goals they should plan. Up to 10 years, what she should get. And how she should plan. That planning is very important. So she should plan during this time for their achievement, for their goals.
Oh,
that
everything,
is me.
everything, every aspect you have to enjoy. This is the, motherhood also you need to enjoy during, well said, during this period. You have to think, you have to upgrade yourself, you have to plan your for the future, what you have the assignments, everything. It's up to you how you can manage and how you can enjoy your life and livelihood. And moving towards the honoring way, ma'am, I received the question in a personal chat, what are the different ways of honoring women in India as we covered our topic by, under this theme? So,
as I already said to you, Preeti, I would like to say my picture is not coming. I think so.
So you need to share a screen share.
Okay, this one?
Your picture?
Yeah.
You are visible here.
Okay.
Just I'm
okay.
You are host, ma'am.
Okay,
just wait. I think you make me co-host.
I don't know. Actually.
Okay. Now is okay?
I don't know. Okay, we proceed. So to honor the woman, networking
you need,
is very
ma'am,
important.
You want to share the presentation?
No. Because I am visible or not, that is important.
You are visible.
Yeah, okay. So for honor of the woman in Indian society.
Yes, ma'am.
Again, particularly in the Indian society, because in the Indian society is very important. And woman is full of energy. They know everything. That's why. And they are very happy with the small things. Like I earlier said, this is just certification course he received, she will be very happy. So networking of the woman, one woman should appreciate to the another woman.
Exactly.
So that is very important. Because the nature of Indian woman is different. As we saw, my personal opinion, as we saw in a in our Indian family system, किसी बेटी का अगर कुछ होता है तो सारा पूरा परिवार मनाता है और बेटे का अगर कुछ होता है तो कहते हैं ठीक है गो ऑन सक्सेस सो दैट फीलिंग्स वी ऑल वुमेन शुड कीप विद दैट सी वी आल्सो इन अ प्रोफेशन वी आल्सो सेलिब्रेट दैट एवरीथिंग इज टू बी सेलिब्रेटेड एंड द नेटवर्किंग ऑफ द वुमेन दे शुड सेलिब्रेट इफ एनी अचीवमेंट एंड इन व्हाट्सएप और इन फेसबुक वी शुड थैंक्स टू दैट So that will make them motivated. That will make them inspired. I have done something. So that happiness feeling and wellness feeling make motivated them. So now this time is a very much important for all women. Being a senior, I always appreciate whatever the new things the young women do. So I always do. So that the students and the younger generations and all the leaders, those are coming in this area. So we all will appreciate. Thank you so much.
Exactly. We women are like they're like a flowers. Small happiness, they will be happy. And the thing is, what they required, just appreciation.
Yes. Yeah.
Whether the mother, sister, in every ways women just want the appreciation, nothing else. So very well, ma'am, you have covered all the aspects and even the honoring way, and you have you have more prone and towards the woman empowerment. It's really a challenge, a tough challenge to bring all the females in a single platform, but it's hats off to you. And I just wanted to know, it's my personal question, that as I already told, that woman has proved in a COVID-19 pandemic condition, still people wants, because so many people joined late. So they just wanted to know, what is the role of Indian women in the management of COVID-19 in our country? So can you enlighten some your experience, what you saw in...
So looking to the Atmanthan, with related to the Atmanthan.
Yeah, exactly.
So first, First, we are person, we are human being. We should be human being. We are human being. So we should be happy or make the near and dear to be happy. So how human nature first, then your life, then come to your profession. If you are happy, then society will be happy. If your surroundings is happy, then you can think for your profession. If only you are doing for your profession, then you can't be happy. So happy society and happy living. So for that purposes, we have contributed. I am also working in NGOs also, because I love that NGOs. So in the NGOs, not only the profession, but in the NGOs, we contributed so many food, water, and the accessories, what is essential for them. And sometimes we have also educated to our other organizations.
Exactly.
How we can proceed for that. How we can do that. And at that time, these 3 months lockdown period.
So how you manage your life?
Rejuvenation, which in a stress area, in a stress and meditation had been started, yoga has been started in full. And health, we have started to look for that. We should be healthy and wealthy, then we can come up and boost our immunity. How we can boost our immunity, how we can use our spices in the kitchen. So what are the routine we should do? So that in which because of our daily life at 10 to 5, we have to go and rush with that, and then stressful life was there. But during this long time period, we have a good life and we have started thinking. No need of too much of the things at the home. So only whatever is basic things are required, that is more than enough. And contribute to the society, whatever in your brain. That is more important. Not lot of things. Yeah.
Really, that's even my next question was something the same, how you can manage your stress and everything, because I in this 3 months I got the chance, like I more used with the Facebook and all this thing. So where the Vigyan Bharati has started some spiritual related activities, I saw you are supposed to be there. So it's really a good thing that so many positivity will gain some knowledgeable sessions we can gain, whatever we can take, so it's for us only. So it's something good.
So as you quote the Vigyan Bharati, I am also the president of this Chhattisgarh prant.
That's good.
This area. So I am the president of that, of our women day. Earlier in the Vigyan Bharati, the women are that time the very small number we are. So, but when the numbers is increases in the world, more women is coming in this other, in this field. So we have separated from them. Now it is known as a Shakti sister concern of the Vigyan Bharati.
Okay.
So now the Shakti is doing a good work, and we have a 22 units. And recently, in 4-5 days before, in lockdown period, we have a 7 more units. Across the world, across this India. So, and we have a 2,000 workers, members in that. And all are working for science, because Vigyan is related to the whatever in routine life we are doing, that is related to our science. So we have prepared a woman status. What are the resolutions of our woman status? 16 volume book. So that resolutions we have also worked. 4-5 units has worked on that. And routine life, whatever we are doing in traditions, in culture, in havan, in yoga, what is the science behind it? How it is helping to our lifestyle? How is it helping in our routine life? So how? What is the science is that? So we have prepared a one booklet. Everybody is releasing their newsletter. And that new things has been rejuvenated. So we have started to see how the science in our life is a science always. So in our traditions, everything is, whatever doing is a science. So what is it? Because nowadays the students and the young generation, they do not believe if they are not knowing the what is behind it. So that interpretation, we 2000 people, women, we 2000 women has described and make a note on that. Whenever it will come, I cannot say, but we will try and within 2 years, it will come out.
Okay. Thank you so much for a wonderful deliberation, ma'am. It's really a honor that you joined the Prizal Atmamanthan talk series. And I just started this talk series apart from the pharma, because the thing is, yes, we should upgrade ourselves. We need to present our feeling, what is inside. So the basic idea is only the, like, you can open hearted, you can talk, you can give your views. So that's why I started. And a whole week we start with the webinar and conferences. Yes. We are just too much with that. So we need some point, we need concentration on our views, our ideas. So this is the only reason we have started this series. And it's again, thanks for accepting my invitation in a shorter span of time. It's really a nice session. And really, last but not the least, I just wanted to know, in this platform, what message you wanted to give to all the participants and all...
By this platform, every woman is a unique woman. They should introspect, and every woman should have a one purpose of life. She should come out from their self. One, she should come out from their self and make her life meaningful, and should be confident that whatever he is thinking is absolute. She can do. That confidence is very important. She can do. She have a power. She can do that. So with their own conditions, own power, own feeling, for their own happiness, for their own work, they should contribute their own life. So meaningful life they have to make them. Not for always for the family or for others. No, you are a wonderful creation of the made, prepared by the God, so you have to contribute. And you are a daughter of the India, not only a one small thing, one small group. So they should feel you are a daughter and you have to contribute for the nation. So what you can do, what are your potential, so you should do.
Thank you so much, ma'am. It's a really wonderful message you have given to all. Thank you. Once again, I just thank wanted you. To thanks. And Netra, can you please share this? Thank you so much. This is, as we are connected, virtual way, and it's like little bit token of appreciation from my side, from Prizal Society, that you have spared your valuable time, your words a lot for me. It's make a whole day, and it's full of positivity. And really, the session you have choose, the honor of women in Indian society, which is really remarkable. Like, each and every woman has their contribution in the field. We need to appraise, that's it. So it's really a wonderful, deliberation from your side, and your thinking, your motivation, and your views for the women and women empowerment. It's really make you yourself unique. So thank you so much, ma'am. And once again, I thanks. And with
thank you for this invitation, Priti, and your team too.
Thank you.
She is Netra and your team also.
Netra, she is from
ma'am,
she is from JSS OT. She is research scholar over there. Okay. Netra, can you please stop? Suddenly screen share, my PowerPoint presentation is not working. So I just called her to. Okay, so in last, ma'am, through this session, what we did, anyone wants to share their views, so we can invite them. So
holiday, any chutti during the lockdown time, and all of them, they have enjoyed their holidays. Okay, over the 2 months, she was the only woman which they were working right from morning to evening. Even in fact, in many of the platforms, people have told the intake of food 3 times have become 6 times. And it was the women which were there to prepare and serve food. Hats off to the contributions being done by the women. In fact, there is no comparison and it cannot be compared at all to the contributions that they are doing. Of respect, they are really definitely being honored. And we are very happy that today what you have arranged the lecture is truly and what Dr. Sarraf has delivered. I congratulate them as well as delivering a great lecture.
Thank you so much.
Hello, Priti.
Hello, ma'am.
Saladuddin sir is here.
Yeah, ma'am.
Sir, I would like to say, this is just a chit-chat. I would like to say, as I told, so traditional mindsets to be changed.
Exactly.
Daughter of India, to first name to become. So always address first name to any woman. So she will feel proud. This is the honor for a woman.
Absolutely.
Yes, sir. Yeah. So civil, first name is always, because as we do in our foreign trips and foreign buses, so in India we also should adopt it.
It will happen, madam, with the time. I do feel that all these women is respected. They are already been given the honor as Lakshmi, Durga, okay, so many honors. Okay, we never taught money. We never tell money, we talk Lakshmi, isn't it? So that is how the honor is always there for the women. So I must say that congratulations for arranging such a wonderful lecture by Professor Preeti Tagade.
Thank you.
Sir, hello.
Yeah,
ma'am. Saladuddin, sir.
Yeah, I'm there.
Sir, I want to say, because this is a platform for the woman as she has given for Atma Manchan. So because this is an Atmanthan, not the pharmacy profession, so that Atmanthan related to that platform. So women in a 100 names has been given. Nari Sarvate Pujyate. Now in modern era, no woman is born to be a devi. They want to be a human being. I think every woman is agree with that.
Exactly.
They don't want to be a devi. Unko devi ka roop dene ki no need of it. But they are the human being. They are a human. So that is more than enough. So then they can contribute for the nation building. If they are a devi, wo to mandir mein baith jayenge. It doesn't matter. So their first name is more than enough.
Amme. Dekho India.
That's good.
India.
Yeah. Ma'am, you unmute yourself. You have muted.
Now it's okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Now it's over, I think so.
Yeah, thank you so much. Once again, thank you so much, ma'am, for coming and sharing your views. And thanks to all the participants for your valuable support and your suggestions. Like you have really enjoyed the session. That's make our day. Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you.